Hi everybody, Namaskaram. Welcome to the Full Moon Sacred Gifts call, where we access the expressions, communications and correspondences of our higher selves. I would like all of us to begin with our hands in Namaste, Namaskara, Anjali Mudra. Please receive this invocation and blessing and thanks to everybody who has touched us, has been our teacher and our master. To our devtas, our deities, our gods, our ascended masters, our angels, our ancestors, our families, our friends, people that we've come across, our rishis, our munis, our teachers, our plants, our animals, the five elements that make up the universe, and us. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Dhyan Moolam Guru Murti, Puja Moolam Guru Padam, Mantra Moolam Guru Vakyam, Moksha Moolyam Guru Kripa. Guru as the creator Brahma, Guru as the preserver Vishnu, Guru as the destroyer Maheshwara, Guru the supreme absolute God. To that Guru we prostrate. The Guru's form is the root of meditation. The Guru's feet are the root of worship. The Guru's word is the root of mantra. The Guru's grace is the root of liberation. Asking for us to completely surrender ourselves, our problems, and the results of every dream that we have. The Guru that is around us is the Guru that we are also made up of. And so, seeking the Guru within, I want you to keep your eyes closed, your palms in Namaskara Mudra, as you see yourself walking down a path, clear path. Maybe there are forests, trees around, maybe there are not. As you're walking down this path, in front of you, you see emerging as you get closer the full moon. So close that if you ran towards it, you could jump and reach it. You continue walking and you start becoming aware of a form, a silhouette taking color, shape and size next to you. You're walking and this is walking with you. Turn to this energy, to this being, smile. Don't be afraid. This is your higher self, always walking with you, always communicating with your masters, with your angels, to send you messages that say, go here, don't go here, say yes, say no. I want you to link your hand with this being's hand. Maybe this being is an older version of you. Maybe this being looks like nobody you've ever met. Maybe this being is in white. Maybe this being is in black. Your higher self has been called on before this call started to walk with you. So you will see the correct being that you are supposed to see. Some of us can sense some more beings around us. And if you do, they are your angels. They are the eagles of your consciousness. Walk together, together, together. If there is someone on the other side of you, link your hand with their hand as well and walk towards the full moon. In this dimension, slowly release your palms. Keep them face downward on your thighs. Straighten your spine, square your shoulders, thrust your chest out as you begin the one way to access your divinity, your eternal master teacher and guru inside your divinity. You're going to breathe in and breathe out through the mouth. You're going to breathe in through the nose and breathe out through the mouth. Breathe in, complete your inhale. Breathe out, complete your exhale. You are now going to take in your inhale from the back of your spine. Your entire spine is going to receive your inhale. Inhale and exhale from the central column in the front of your body. Inhale, inhale, inhale. Exhale from the front of your body. Your breath is your constant communication with the universe. In every breath, you release, you receive. Inhale through your spinal column. Exhale through the front. Exhale through the front. Inhale through your spinal column. Inhale from the front, your central column. Your central column is the column in which your chakras reside. So they are the front of your spine, but they are straight, whereas your spine has curves. Inhale through the central column. Exhale through the spine. Make sure that you are not slouching. If you have, bring yourself back into the correct position to receive the best of your breath. Inhale through the central column. Exhale through the spine. Inhale. Exhale from the back. Inhaling, pulling the full moon, pulling the future in, exhaling everything in the past that's holding you back. Inhale now through your upper back spine, that is the back of your chest. Inhale, exhale through your lower abdomen. Inhale from the top back. Exhale from the lower bottom front. Inhale, complete your inhale. Exhale, complete your exhale. Contract your stomach till you have no exhale left. Inhale from the front of your chest. Let your lungs rise. Let your chest come up. Inhale through the front of your chest. Exhale through your lower back. Inhale from the front of your chest. Exhale from the lower back. As you do this, you will automatically find your spine elongating, more space between the vertebrae for the magic of prana in the breath to do its work. Inhale from the front of your chest. Exhale from your lower back. Inhale from the top of your head. Exhale from your perineum, the space between your secret space and your anus. Inhaling therefore from the crown chakra, exhaling from the Muladhara. Inhaling from the crown, exhaling from the Mooladhara. Allowing this flow to continue, you're going to inhale from a channel right next to it through the Mooladhara, exhale from the crown chakra. This breath is activating both your central column as well as your spine. It will release, take care and clear of every debris, toxin and stuck energy that has come up when we did the first exercise of breathing in from the back and exhaling from the front. Inhaling from the Mooladhara, pulling up the breath as you inhale, and when you exhale, see it shooting out from the crown in both directions, falling around you like a fountain. The fountain reaches the floor. Inhale from the soles of your feet. Inhale, 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 inhale as you pull up the breath. Exhale from the top of your head in a fountain going both sides, falling down and back again. Inhale from the soles of your feet, coming up, coming up, coming up. Exhaling from the top. Inhaling from the top. Inhale as you push down your prana to the soles of your feet, and on the exhale, flushing out from the soles of your feet, rising up in a fountain and meeting in the center of your head again. Inhale, pull in the breath downwards, reach the soles of your feet, exhale, let the breath go into the flow. Simultaneously now, experience the flow of energy coming down from the head to the Mooladhara as well as going up from the Mooladhara to the head. Don't think it. Don't use the left brain. Only your awareness. Aware of the flow downwards, aware of the flow upwards. Both cycles of prana taking place from top to bottom and bottom to top. I now want you to see the circles around you. Your eyes have been closed from the beginning till now. As you are walking down that path, I want you to see these circles of energies around you. These circles of energy encompass the ones that you're walking with. You are physically seeing layers of energy as they flow in from the top of your head, come out from your groin, go back up. As they come in from your groin, Mooladhara, go back up, come down. As they come in from the top of your head, come out from the soles of your feet, go back up into the head. As they come in from the soles of your feet and out through the back of the head, flowing down. I want you to see these lines, these concentric circles, semicircles. I want you to start seeing the energies of you. The moon is very close now. You only have a little bit more to walk. You've almost reached the moon. In the moonshine, these circles and layers around you start reflecting colors. What is your color? What is the color? What is the color around you? What is the color of your higher self? What are these colors? I want you to become one with these colors. No more even analyzing what the color is. you and the colors are one. And as the moonshine beams its concentrated light on you, you, your higher self, your ascended masters, your angels, all integrate within in this explosion of light, white, bright colors. And you and the moon ray are now one. You no longer see yourself on the path because you have now merged with the light of the moon. Leave yourself there. Bring the curtains down on this. Return. Rub your palms. Cup your eyes. Blink. 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 Slowly bring your palms down. Open your eyes gently. Turn your neck from left to right. Gently look upwards towards the ceiling. Look down towards your thighs or your feet. Interlock your fingers of both hands. Raise your hands up. Stretch. Stretch. Turn to one side. Turn to the other side. Come down. Return to your breath. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. Have some water. And all in one flow. The moment you finish having water, begin your Tratak. Tratak is the act of focusing on a particular point. Our point is the candle that is in the picture where we are chatting. I want you to see the candlelight. I want you to start focusing on where you can see the blue right at the base of the flame, the black of the wick. The non-color but mild darkness around that. I want you to start slowly raising your eyes to the middle of the flame. And I want you to start becoming aware of the aura of the flame. On one side is a tiny, tiny auric pink color, become aware of it. If you wear glasses, please wear your glasses. We will do Tratak with them on. And now bring all your attention to the tip of the flame. You're going to keep looking at this till either your eyes water and close, or the picture starts glazing and your eyes close. But keep looking at it without blinking till your eyes close. When your eyes close, you will start seeing either light in your third eye or a circle of light. You will spend as long as you like looking at it till it fades out. Look at the tip of the flame. when you have experienced the light, the flame, the circle in your third eye, then gently open your eyes and look one more time at the tip of the candle flame. This time, even when you start having the reaction, I want you to hold on and keep staring for another 10 seconds. And once again, you're going to close your eyes. This time, you're going to move the candlelight from your third eye into your heart chakra. So I want you to see how the flame travels to your heart chakra from your third eye. Your breath can take it there. The power of your mind can take it there. Go ahead, begin your second round. If you cannot see any visual, I want you to just close your eyes and imagine a small flame in your third eye. And bring that flame down to your heart chakra. As you do this, in the distance, a song plays. Slowly, as you release your Tratakwa, you start using your ears to sense the song in a language that we've all forgotten. Latin.
Thank you.
Whatever the song would have brought up, I want you to ride the waves. Clairsentience. Feel whether you could connect to the music, to the sound, to the words, whether you couldn't. Whatever is coming up, I want you to flow with it. Take 2 minutes. And just let the music still play somewhere in the body. You come back to this dimension open your eyes, have some water. As some of you might already be experiencing, we are going deeper and deeper. More than 75% of our body is water. The moon handles water. Neptune, who's retrograde right now, is the lord of the oceans. As we sink deeper, depending on what is at the bottom of the ocean or in the depths of the ocean, we might feel heavy or we might feel light. We might feel anxious or we might feel excited. Either way, you are now going to sit comfortably, make your back supported, relaxed. Keep your palms upwards now, because for a few moments, and just for a few moments, we are going to float on the ocean. Remember, your masters, angels, and higher self have integrated, become one with you. Float, just float. Find yourself drifting, relaxing, sinking, and as if by magic, a new wave of energy, strength, light starts flowing through you. Remember the flame in the heart? It starts spreading. And as if you are your own candle in the middle of the ocean, you send a beam up. Your beam encircles the sky, move beyond. This is the power of your gift. There's nothing you cannot do. Your life still on, you start swimming to the shore. All the waves support you, come faster to the shore. You reach the shore. Your light is burning bright. You are wet, but not cold. You have come to this place for a very important reason. on this shore, some distance away from you, are those who have hurt you, harmed you, terrorized you, traumatized you, abused you, misused you, used you. They are the ones who brought to you life's biggest challenges, crises, and heartbreaks. These are your most important gurus. Stand tall, stand straight. Point the beam coming out from your heart chakra towards all of these people. Every situation in your life that's been tough would have been characterized by one person. See them all and start running your light through them. And as you run your light through them, you say blessings and gratitude to you. 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 Until it is a tape playing as the light cuts across all of them. Maybe some of them need more of your light. Stay and say blessings and gratitude to you. No situation or person can stay longer than their giving, whether that's the giving of love or whether that's the giving of a learning. When your light shines and you send them blessings and gratitude, your higher self will start revealing the magic and the gift of those challenges and those challenging people. So you will start seeing them disappear or turn away, walk away, start disintegrating. Do not involve the left brain or the mind at all to try and start remembering who or what these situations or people are. They will reveal themselves to you. You are working only with your breath, your manifesting decrees, and your knowing. When you are done, you will automatically see yourself coming out of the moon where you had disappeared into, had become one with the moonlight. You will see yourself falling or jumping out of the moon back on the path. The moon starts rising to its place in the sky. And you start walking your path again. You are not alone. You have everybody and everything you need. Countless, limitless support, love, reassurance, comfort, energy, bandwidth. See yourself walking. You are now not stuck anymore. It has been removed. You are not being held back anymore. It has been removed. You have the right and the choice and the power to walk ahead and carry on. The universe makes way for the one who keeps walking. see yourself go towards your happy ending, towards your many happy endings. Leave yourself there, bring the curtains down. Come back to this dimension. Rub your palms. Cup your eyes. Blink, blink, blink. Bring your palms down without opening your eyes. And start becoming aware of your beautiful feet, soles of your feet, toes of your feet, the front of your feet. Start becoming aware of your inner and outer ankles on both feet. Bring your attention upwards to your shins and your calves, knees, back of the knees, thighs, back of the thighs, your bum, your pelvic, your lower abdomen, your lower back, your middle abdomen, your middle back, your upper abdomen, your upper back, your chest, and the rest of your upper back. Front of your shoulders, top of your shoulders, back of your shoulders. Simultaneously taking your attention down, your palms, becoming aware of your fingers, your thumb, your index, your middle, your ring, your little finger. Traveling back through your wrists, your elbows, your shoulder joints, and coming to the awareness of your neck, throat, back of the neck, base of the skull, back of the head, ears on the sides, forehead. Taking a U-turn and becoming aware of your jaws, your lips, your mouth, your tongue, your cheeks, your nose, and finally all attention at your eyes. Open them little bit. Close them. Open them. Close them. Open them midway. Close them. Open them fully. Close them. Open them. Have a sip of water. Tell me how you're doing. Some of y'all couldn't hear me because of the wave sound. Could also be the sound of the rain in my background. Whatever you could follow is fine. In our work, what we were doing was going beyond our 3D senses. Clairvoyance, the dignity of our eyes. Clairaudience, the dignity of our ears. Clairsentience, the divinity of our feelings. Claircognizance, the divinity of our knowing. Vinita says, awesome experience, felt powerful on my way back. That is what I am looking for. How were you when you restarted your journey? Can you feel more grounded, more present, more available, like there's more of you now? Naveen says, lots of tears in my eyes. Did you allow yourself to float on this emotion that dropped the tears, Naveen? all emotions are water. When we were floating on the ocean, we were allowing ourselves to be the master of our emotions. At the same time, allowing the ocean to float however it was floating. Maybe some of y'all rode some high waves. Maybe some of y'all just drifted. The state of your ocean is the state of your emotion. When we can lie down on an ocean, that means I am of my emotions, but I am in charge of them. Dynamic balance. Meher said, we are all rising to full potential of love and yes, more focus. Superb. Daisy says, feel sleepy and relaxed. Fantastic. Some of y'all might find it difficult to actually pay attention to my voice now. That's because the work that was started when you started the path, when you started the strata, when you went into the moon, that work is still continuing. So don't force yourself to listen in. You always have the replay. And hey, we have next month's full moon as well. Just tell me that you're fine, that you will pay attention to your dreams and the messages and the insights and the guidances, and that you will be fully aware, awake, woke, as do the opportunities coming in 24 hours. Linda says, felt stronger for sure. Nishi is floating, beautiful, and love the ocean, fantastic. Sudha says, so freeing and so powerful. She says, thank you and blessings and gratitude to you. Thank you, my darling. How was it for y'all to see these people, to see these challenging situations represented by a person and run your light through them? Did they disappear? Did they disintegrate? Did they turn and walk away? Was there calm and peace between you and them? Nishtha says, feeling so calm, energized, so much love, comfort, peace and strength. Beautiful acceptance of myself and love of the entire universe. I am the light. Thank you, my darling. Thank you for saying that. One of the best experiences of my life. And Cornelia is feeling very peaceful as well. Crystal says, I teared up heavily the minute Ave Maria started. Right now, I feel a bit stoned. You know, it's one of the reasons why we do turn to well, being stoned. To grass, to weed, to opium, to any other drugs that are not coming to my mind right now. We look for this high that comes when we connect with our own senses. Not that we are not connected to our senses. We all are. Our senses tell us, wear a sweater. Our senses tell us, don't go there. Our senses tell us, I'm hungry now. We're always connected to our senses. But the divinity, sacred energy behind our senses, oh, that is a high. Thelma says, so exhilarating as well as peaceful. Many images occurred. Music cleared out stickiness and music settled in my legs and heart. My body flowed with the waves, feel expanded. If you respond to music like that, Thelma, your gift is the gift of clairaudience, the divinity of our ears. Rita says, heavy head, you must rest, my love. Keep your food very simple. No heavy carbs. Carbs are allowed, but no heavy carbs. No animal protein. Lots of water, depending on the weather where you are. Lots of green tea. Lots of rest. There is dehydration here. Ramlan says, I'm filled with love. I'm with my higher self, wept with Ave Maria, my being was Ave Maria, my dad sang it too. Wow, it must have been amazing. Ave Maria is a hymn. So it has surrender, it has love, it has gratitude, it has the acknowledgement of blessings. It is a most gentle hymn. Swati says, love the floating, could see lovely pink, purple color. Beautiful. Vaishali says, happy ending. Could see my dream house door and lots of yawning. Fantastic. Elizabeth says, a version of myself for singing the Ave Maria. Then so much clearing out of the bottom of the ocean, floated to the top, and was all cleared off. Cleared on a calm ocean top. That's beautiful. You know, in the middle of the ocean, there was this sense to go to the bottom. But the bottom of the ocean can have many a darkness and frightening demons for those of us who are not practicing and working with our awareness and through our awareness. So I skipped that part. But actually with the ocean, especially with Neptune retrograde, to dive into the ocean, to get to the bottom means not only will we face our beasts, but we will come back with the treasure chest that hides at the bottom of the seabed. Bindu says, feeling free and light. Monique says, feel lots of freedom and joy while walking my path now. Fantastic. Linata says, empowered, aware, open, and agrees that yes, there is more of me. Do you see how much more present you are with you? She says, dolphins around me while floating, but peaceful. Fantastic. She says, jitters all over my body, hearing Ave Maria, pleasant, and smile on. Beautiful. For Linda, everybody that we shone a light on and sent blessings and gratitude, they disappeared, including, she says, my present ones. I love it. You see what happens for you, my darlings. Two things always happen when we do any kind of energy work and receive energy medicine and energy blessings. And this is either whatever is troubling you will have a solution, or you will just not be troubled by it anymore. I'm saying it, but I also mean people. So either they will not trouble you so much anymore, or you will not be troubled by them anymore. In working with energy medicine, energy blessings, energy expansion, like in today's call with your gifts, you have moved to another higher vibration. The usage of our clairs, our divinity, our sacredness is a 5D way of living. In 5D, we have very little use for actual word, verbal communication. When we speak, it will always be to empower somebody or uplift somebody else. Everything else we will handle on our own because we have everybody and everything that we need to do so. This is so amazing. This is so good. Tejasri says, floating part is super. Waves were high and low. However, the part where I was calm. Lots of tears, only through the right eye. Pain in right hand was at a 5, now down to 3. Remaining pain, you can leave now. Remaining pain, you can leave now. Remaining pain, you can leave now. Dr. Asha was sitting on the ocean bed and floating, safe with all the sharks around. They just passed by, no harm. Fantastic. Swati asks, how often can we do Tratak? Once a day is very good. I recommend that Tratak be done after either some amount of yoga or some amount of meditation. Like, don't straight away go to Tratak. It's harder. Because Tratak is about bringing the mind to a focused point. And if the mind has been chattering and you've been doing other stuff, you've been running around, and you sit down to do Tratak, it'll take much longer. So if you've done something, gone for a walk, done some yoga, done some meditation, Tratak will happen more simply. Allison says, my path seemed very clear and felt like it was my path when returned. Sat with my inner child on the ocean floor. By the way, my darling, the you that you saw was your inner child, because for the higher self, we are always the inner child. Preeti says, loved flame and sound waves, feeling peace within. Did you all see the flame flicker as you continued to gaze at it? Did you see the aura around the flame become stronger? Like you could make out more colors, you could make out more form and more shape. And Thelma says, I'm fine and delighted with my dreams and experiences. It was so great to see the challenges and realize that I rose up and loved and lived through these people. Beautiful. Sonal has to go through the replay, but she says, I could see many go away after giving them light, blessings, and gratitude. Beautiful. Happy Guru Purnima to all, she says. Thank you, Sonal. Happy Guru Purnima to you. And I appreciate very much that you said thanks to the Mystic Lotus team, because they've been there from the beginning till now. Shilpa, Amrish, and Neelu. Thank you. Jack says, very peaceful. Garima says, as soon as the music played, I was floating on the ocean. And thank you very much for saying that, my love. I was wanting the floating to begin, actually, with the music. Vision was very clear, she says, and I could also smell the sea. That's amazing. That's absolutely amazing. Because clair smelling is also a clair. Vandana says, feeling light, started seeing rainbow color circles, then white light next to me, enjoyed every moment with pink and white light and heart chakra, traveling in a carriage of white horse, sailing in golden round boat with angel fairies. Wow. After saying gratitude to all, I walked so confidently, feeling so strong and proud, saw images of Lord Shivji, Supreme Mother, Lord Jesus Christ, and Mother Mary, feeling so blessed, very excited and joyful all over, body is vibrating with energy. This is the absolute energy that we want to take on a full moon, especially on a Guru Purnima full moon. For the next day, my darlings, when the lunar eclipse is supposed to be on us, I would like you to keep a candle lit throughout the day and as much as possible throughout the evening and the night. Tomorrow, if you have a light outside your door, I want you to keep that on throughout the night. Let the candle burn outside this door. Whenever the candle goes off in the evening, it goes off in the evening. Whenever the candle goes off in the morning, it goes off in the morning. If you have other candles in the house and you like to light them, please do so tomorrow. Some of our disruptions, digital disruptions, as well as some of the heaviness that could have come or us not being able to hear, would have also happened with some influence from the eclipse coming up. Sumati says, I was flowing and swaying, very comfortable riding the waves, on a high, merged with the moon, feeling stronger and in control, loved the depth of the ocean, picked up pearls and gems and distributed them. Beautiful. Nishi, yes, I played the Celine Dion Ave Maria version. Radha says, I'm a water girl, loved every experience with the water and ocean, especially since I'm unable to connect with water due to lockdown, loved all aspects of the water, waves brushing against my skin, people seem very distant now, can't recognize them, overall very enriching, fantastic. Tejashree says, song was beautiful, saw myself in an opera, in a divine couple dancing on stage, got a glimpse of Abraham Lincoln in a balcony, didn't get why, but then was lost in the song, and you may have seen another lifetime, my darling. Donna says, there was definitely peace. I was wondering how I could clear and let these people go. Ave Maria is my most favorite, cried. I used to cry so much listening to Ave Maria once upon a time. Now I can feel. This was a beautiful, sorry, that little bit over there was my own interjection, wasn't Donna saying it. Donna says, I feel more calm, stronger. I did remember while I was floating that I had saved my mother from drowning. I feel I am slowly and surely reclaiming my dignity. So glad, my darling. So glad. Thank you, Romlin. Thank you. Nilesh says, almost dozed off, uncontrollable, absolutely fine. Till we begin to have the awareness required to work with our clairs will continue to do the work that they do, but they'll have to make us sign out. So don't worry at all, my love. You still received much good. Udita says, head is quite heavy. Have to rest, my darling. Please have a very light meal. Head is heavy means lots from the tummy would have also come up. So stay light, fast if you can. Have a great, lovely big breakfast tomorrow. Mona, this will become the replay. This link will become the replay in about a few moments after we have finished the call. Elizabeth says, loved exploring the ocean. The state of your ocean is the state of your emotions. Is that what you said? Yes, my darling. I like being at the bottom and clearing it out. Were we beaming light out of our heart towards the others? I saw that, but it was also directed within me. Beautiful. Yes, we were. Especially those who have caused us distress and disturbances. Vani says, was not able to do it. Probably my mind was working. Did not understand. And when we get the replay, can we do it on a normal day, not a full moon day? My darling, I suggest that it be done on a full moon day. And don't worry, Ma. You are a new entrant into the world of energy medicine. You will get there. Just join us again on the next full moon call. I'm also going to be doing a new moon call. I think the new moon is on the 22nd. I will check and put it up. Come for that as well. Cornelia says, I felt so safe on the water. Fantastic. Linda, the word I used was Sratak. Sratak is the activity we did when we were focusing on the tip of the candle. And for Garima, the flame was purple in the center, white around, traveled in the same color as it traveled from the third eye to the heart. Beautiful. Thank you, Vaishali. Happy Guru Purnima. And Tejashree says, yes, the candle flickered. I saw a shadow growing behind it. However, it was gone as we continued. Fantastic. Thank you, Mona. Thank you so much. On behalf of the Mystic Lotus team, Neelu, Amrish, Shilpa, Ruchira, Mizbah, I receive blessings and gratitude. Multiply them and send it to them. Lena says, my third eye and eyes are hurting. I think I store energy there. Not good at all. What can I say? My love, I would like you to hold your middle finger and ring finger simultaneously on your left side. Just keep holding it with your eyes closed for 5 minutes. Tejashree, if you have a white and black candle, I recommend the black candle for eclipse days. I also recommend a black candle on new moon days. And by the way, my darling, for the new moon call, please have a candle lit, any color, any shape, any size, close by to you. Thank you, Sally. Thank you. It is one of my biggest joys in a call to be able to interact and read the comments. Thank you so much. For Romlin, as weeping as she sang with Ave Maria, her dad was also singing in Dimensions Beyond. Fantastic. Fantastic. Nishna saw Shivji on one side, lady in white flowing dress, third eye was throbbing from the start, floated on a calm sea, cried when saw all the people that hurt me, felt relaxed and calm. Thank you again to all the Mystic Lotus team, doubling it, multiplying it, sending it to the Mystic Lotus and Dragonflies team. Thank you so much My darling, thank you. Vandana, I would recommend that if possible, you do this call before 6 a.m. tomorrow morning, if at all you want to repeat it. Otherwise, gently let it go. We are going to be doing a next set of sacred gifts, full moon call on full moon. And before that, we're going to be meeting for the new moon call. And before that, we're going to be meeting on Lord Ganpati Tuesday. This time, we're going to be doing the question and answer session for Saturn's decrees. Like everything that you wanted to know but didn't know where and how, Tuesday is that call. I want all details on the group. I wish you and y'all a wonderful Sunday. Please rest a lot, take a break, or put your feet up, enjoy your me time, keep the candles burning inside the house, and if you can, outside the house, with the outside house light lit as well. Good night, everybody, or good morning, good afternoon. Big love, big hug. Namaste from India.